Hey, math class, I just wanted to do one last factor reducing video. Today in class, I didn't intend for the computer to give you such big, huge numbers in fractions to reduce down. And I know I talked to some of you sort of individually about this technique that I use for reducing really big numbers, but I wanted to show it to everybody to make sure that you all kind of understand. So again, when we're reducing, we're finding a factor, a number smaller than either one of these two that I'm going to divide out, okay? So reducing, we're dividing, we're making it a smaller fraction. In this problem, though, like, I don't know about you, but I don't really want to find a list of factors for both of these super huge numbers. Frankly, I am too lazy and I have better things to do with my time. So I'm going to give you a tip. What I do is I go through a checklist in my head. Okay? I never start with one. I can divide one out of anything, and it really doesn't make a whole lot of sense because it's not going to change this fraction, is it? I always start with two. Could I divide two out of both of these numbers? Well, this one's even, and this one's even, so yes, I could. I could divide two out of both of those numbers. I think I'm going to start with that and see where it takes me. So I'm going to divide both of these by two to get a new fraction, okay? Let me grab another board here because I'm going to do my math on this other board over here. Okay, 2 into 90. 2 goes into 9 4 times, which is 8. I have 1 left over. Drop my 0 down. 2 into 10 goes 5 times. 5 times 2 is 10. And I have no remainder, which is good. It goes in evenly. Okay, so the new top of my fraction over here I've just found is 45. Okay? Back to my work here. I'm going to go 2 into 144 now. Well, I can't go 2 into 1, so I have to go into that 14, which is 7. 7 times 2 is 14. I have none left there. I'm going to drop that 4 down. 2 into 4 goes twice, which is 4. Ba-ba-da! There is my new denominator. Okay, oh gosh, now I have to look at this and try to figure out what goes into both of those. Well, I know that 2 can't work, right? Because 45 is odd. It would go into 72, but I have to divide the same thing out of both of these. And so it's not going to work in 45. It's not going to work to reduce this fraction. What about 3, though? I wonder. Let's give it a try. Let me grab another workspace here. I wonder if 3 can go into 45. Okay, 3 can go into 4 one time. Minus 3 is 1. Drop my 5. Oh, look at that. It does. It goes in evenly. 3 times 15 is 45. Okay, I wonder if it would go into 72. I'm going to scooch this over a little bit so you can see the work I'm doing here. 3 goes into 7. How many times? It goes twice. 3 times 2 is 6. I have 1 left over. I'm going to drop down the 2. 3 into 12 goes 4 times. Oh my gosh, it does. So I'm going to come back over here. I can divide 3 out of both of these. Okay, and I end up with 45 divided by 3, I found out was 15. 72 divided by 3, I found out was 24. I still don't feel like I have that reduced down as far as it can go. I think I still have just a little bit more work to do. So I'm going to look at 15. Would 2 work to divide out of both of those? It would work for 24, but 15 is an odd number, so I can't divide 2 out of it. But what about 3 for this again? I think that works as well. And again, some of you probably had this problem, so you know the answer that I'm heading towards anyway, but I thought it was a good example of what you can do. Okay, 15 divided by 3 I know is 5, and 24 divided by 3 is 8. And so, is this reduced down as far as it can go? Well, I see that 5 is prime, So the only way I can reduce it down is if 8 can be divided evenly by 5, right? Because the only factors of 5 are 1 and 5. It's a prime number. So, and 8 can't be divided evenly by 5, so I know that I'm done. So 90 over 144 equals 5/8, okay? So you don't always have to use greatest common factor. If, for example, we had, I'm trying to think of another, if I had if I had a fraction like this, then I could use greatest common factor. I could figure out that my factors of 20, what are my factors of 20? Well, I have 1 and 20, right? And I have 4 and 5. Oh, and I forgot a couple. 2 and 10, right? Those are the factors of 20. And what are the factors of 32? Oh, gosh. 1 and 32. 2 and 16. 3 can't go in. 4 can go in 8 times, though. Okay. Here are my factors. I can see, oh, yes. Look, there's my greatest common factor, right? I can divide 4 out of both of these to end up with 5/8. So if I have a smaller fraction like this, smaller, less terrifying looking numbers, then I totally want to use the greatest common factor if possible, okay? But if I have, like up here, I have big numbers, then do it in increments, right? Because that will sort of make it easier and make the numbers like smaller and smaller and less of a pain to work with. So hopefully that made sense. Don't forget this factor thing. We're going to be moving on to working with some multiples. Remember, the multiples are many, factors are few. We want to remember the difference of that, and so don't forget this reducing stuff. It's really important, even though we're moving on to new stuff. Okay, thanks. Hopefully that makes more sense.